please welcome Alex Horne and the Horne Section. could you introduce the band, Alex?
I would love to, yeah. We've got Ed Sheldrake on piano, a former child. We've got the Mark Brown and Joe Auckland, the twins, on horns. Ben Reynolds, who is the lowly drummer, who's got a star sign. Got Will Collier on bass, who used to... Well, he's a member of the National Front.
National Trust.
National Trust.
Can you kick us off maybe with some music? Something musical? You've got
yeah,
a band.
Well, Joe said not to worry too much, so we've wrote something in the minibus on the way up. And it's a true story, but it doesn't have a... We haven't given it a name yet. It's untitled, like my dog, like my pet dog.
You haven't named your dog?
No, just dog. Doesn't matter. He doesn't mind. He knows no different. It's just dog. He thinks he's Doug, but dog. Shall we do our song?
Let's do a song, yeah. Let's.
Is it the fuzz?
Is it the fence?
Is it the rotters?
Is it the cops?
Is it the bill?
Is it the 5-0?
Is it the pigs?
Is it the filth?
Is it the narcs?
Is it some bobbies?
Is it Bergerac?
No!
It's a highway maintenance vehicle!
We could sing a little song if you want, just to say, you know, hello, if you want.
That'd be fabulous. Could,
yeah, OK. Ready?
One, two.
Here we go.
You know your love lifted me higher than I've ever been lifted before. So keep it up, quench my desire, and I'll be at your side forevermore. Your love on lifting.
Hiya! Hiya!
And...
Hello.
There we go. Unfortunately, because we have a guest saxophonist, we have to focus on the saxophone, which is a shame because it's a horrible instrument. But, but what we do like is, of course, the solo from Baker Street. You know the Baker Street sax solo?
Oh,
the best piece
yeah.
of music in the world. And we have a theory that if you insert that in any other bit of music, it will improve it. So we thought we'd demonstrate that. I'll pick a song, and then if you want to pick any bit of music, Jimmy. So we're going to sing, first of all, a song by Philip Collins. And then I'll point at Pedro and he'll do the solo to Baker Street to make it better. Here we go.
I can feel it humming in the air tonight.
Can't really sing.
I've been waiting for this moment all my life. Oh Lord, oh Lord.
Better, better, better. It works with anything. It works with any bit of music, anything at all. What do you want, Jimmy?
Ness and Dorma.
Agadoo?
Agadoo.
Agadoo.
Yeah, I know it. Yeah, we'll do Ness and Dorma and Agadoo.
Okay, great.
You're genuinely excited by Agadoo.
Well, it needs improving yeah. more than Ness yeah. and Dorma. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, Alex, let's hear Agadoo.
Okay, here we go.
One, two, three.
I think it makes it worse.
As you know, I'm a great dancer and a really nice guy. And today, we've been heavily influenced by the local heroes, the village people. So we thought we'd do a dance inspired by them, if that's all right with you.
Well, that would be fabulous.
So it's going to be me and the little guys, Mark and Joe. So can you welcome us to the dance area, please? Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome to the dance area.
Yes.
Old car, when your tires are bald, you won't start, especially in the cold, the man told you, but you didn't understand. It's a crankshaft piston problem.
Your brake dance covered with the AA. You're always covered with the AA. They have everything for young men to enjoy. You can hang out with all the boys.
Taxes, we all love to pay our taxes. I pay mine every day, but Jimmy Carr knows you can't get away. They will hunt you down and kill you.
You should be frightened of the HMRC. They're very thorough at the HMRC. You could get yourself free. You could have a good meal. You could do whatever you feel.
Young man, there's no need to use words. It's much quicker if you just use letters. So if I'm rolling on the floor, laughing my arse off and can't operate properly till eyes refocus.
You should just type R-O-F-L-M-A-O-C-O-P-T-E-R. You should just type R-O-F-L-M-A-O-C-O-P-T-E-R. They have everything for young men to enjoy at the Rufflemalcopter.
The Rufflemalcopter.
We're going to sing a song now, and we'd like you to eat some peas during it. We're going to provide some peas, and these are from the banjo player's family pea farm. He is from a long line of pea farmers. Your granddad is still working on the farm, is that right, John?
Oh, yeah.
What does your granddad do on the farm?
He grades the peas.
He grades the peas, and they have a simple system of A, and then it's B.
A to D.
A to D on the farm. Okay, so we're going to sing Joe's granddaddy's pea song, and you can tuck into some peas. Here we go.
Granddaddy and I did toil from morn to sundown, hands in soil. We grew those sweet green peas until our fingers they were raw. The peas were ripe, the pods they grew. The sweet green peas were all we knew. We'd pick them all with just the two of us down in the fields. Granddaddy would then grade the peas to check for those anomalies. If it didn't score an A, you see, he'd throw the darn pea out. There was a special song he'd sing. He'd sing it as he sorted through. Next time you might think of him when we sell our peas to you.
This is the top of the crop, and if it wasn't, you would blame us. Grade A, B, you see. We don't serve grade B or C. We never stoop down to D. So you can taste the anus. You can taste the anus in your mouth. You can taste the anus. You can taste the anus. You can taste the the freshness, taste the greenness, taste the sweetness, really taste the peanuts. Granddaddy tastes the anus, so you can taste the peanuts. Granddaddy tastes the anus, so you can taste the peanuts. Granddaddy tastes the anus, so you can taste the peanuts. Taste the freshness, taste the greenness, taste the sweetness, really taste the peanuts.
thought of dear old grandmama, the real brains behind the farm. While granddad had grade A for tea, he'd pop her off with B or C. So late at night she'd sneak around, she picked the best peas that she found. She had the sweetest peas of all. She played granddaddy for a fool.
For a fool.
Oh my goodness.
Introduce us to the band.
Well, listen, yeah, we could only fit half the band, so we've got the worst half, and we've got, my oldest friend, we've got Ben on drums and John on...
Joe
on trumpet, and, and you'll know Will Collier on bass from the Will Collier Septet, the jazz ensemble that was once described...
Once again to Dictionary Corner. Alex Horne, what have you got for us?
We're going to tell you a story, a children's story, sort of combining music and spelling, if that's all right. We're going to spell out some of the words in the story using musical letters, so A to G are the notes. So it's about a B. So, Joe, can you, or Nick, it is Joe, isn't it? Yeah. Joe. Do you want to give us a B? And then an E. And then an E. So that's B, so that's how it's going to work. And the B in the story is... there aren't many letters to play with, so the B is called Bag Face.
Excellent. Take it away, yeah.
Gentle children's story. OK.
Once upon a time, there was a B called Bag Face. B-A-G-F-A-C-E. That's how it works. Story about a bee. Bagface had a lot of emotional baggage. B-A-G-G-A-G-E. That's a bee. So Bagface, he went to bed. B-E-D. We're halfway. Poor old bedridden Bagface. Bagface, he felt caged. A-G-E-D. And then one day, Bagface was found hanging in an apartment in Tokyo, which he'd rented, by a sort of noose, which he'd made out of a noodle, like he sort of strung it up, and it was surrounded by just debris, detritus, and... it's just a bee, and he was dead. D-E-A-D!
Time to go across the Dictionary Corner. Alex Horne and the Horn section. What have you got for us?
We're going to sing a song, Jimmy.
Oh.
And it's for you, because we always have such a nice time here. So we're going to sing a song, and it's a challenging one for any vocalist, even for me. So I'm going to use this. And can I have an E, please, Ed?
When I wake up in the morning, love, and the sunlight hurts my eyes, and something without warning, love, bears heavy on my mind, then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day. Yeah.
question.
It's nice to see behind the glitz and the glamour of the music industry, so I thought we could interview the most flamboyant member of the band, Joe, the little trumpeter. So he's going to come and sit in the interview chair, and I'm going to ask him some questions in the form of a song, and we'll find out what goes on in his little mind. So it's a duet interview. OK. You ready?
Yep.
Yeah, you nervous?
Yep.
OK. Okay. Yep.
What's your favourite season?
Spring's my favourite season.
What's the flaming reason that spring's your favourite season?
I like to hear the robin sing, makes me feel the joy within. I like to smell the chestnuts roast, and on the fire the crumpets toast.
But the robin sings in winter, is it winter that you're into?
Yes, then it must be winter.
What's your favourite season?
I reckon winter's my favourite season.
What's the ruddy reason the winter's your favourite season?
I like the heat upon my back as I walk down the country track, to feel the sun upon my face, the long warm days and your embrace.
But it's not hot in winter, is it summer that you're into?
Yes, then it must be summer.
What's your favourite season?
I think we've established summer's my favourite season.
You've said every other season. Do you understand the seasons?
Yes, I like those leaves of golden brown.
No, that's autumn, you're a clown.
I like the flowers when in bloom.
No, that's spring, you thick baboon. You must have a favourite season.
But I don't understand the seasons. What's your favourite season?
Mine is definitely February.
Like a lot of people here, we've spent the last year really getting into Zumba. So we thought we'd do a little Zumba routine. And because they're in the lead, I think John and Josh are going to join us on the Zumba floor to...
Are we?
To take... Yeah, that's all right, to take part. So we'll do the... we're going to do the... Yeah.
John, Josh, if you'd like to Zumba, please.
Yeah.
Do you want to do it here? Yeah. John Richardson zumbering with that moustache. It's a treat for the ladies. I mean...
Do I go on this side?
You go that side, yeah. We've also got Ed, the pianist? Pianist. OK, so can I have some Zumba bass, please, Willow? OK. Ready? Just loosen up.
I'm right on the edge.
You missed a high five. There we go. So just start with a merengue march. So it's just like that. Just a merengue march. Just rotate the hips. Thumbs up if you can. Thumbs up. That's it. Clench the teeth. Clench the teeth. Just look dead behind the eyes. Fine. Now it's two steps to the right. Two steps to the right. Here we go. And flick. Flick your feet if you can. Flick. That's it. And flick. That's nice. Two more of these. Just relax. Flick. And then get ready with the arms. Awkward arms. Right and left and right and right and left and right and left and left. And left. And double time. Right, right, left, right, left, left. And clap! And shake, just shake your chest. And clap! And shake, that's lovely. And clap! And now your leg, twice. Okay, clap, clap, clap.
Where is your egg?
You should have an egg. Egg. So just a bit of stretching now, a bit of stretching. Here we go. To the left, to the right, to the left. Star jump! Star jump! Down!
And now it's Christmas. Obviously, it's Christmas. Mm. I was wondering if you could play us something sort of a bit Christmassy, the horn section.
Yes, we could sing a carol.
Oh, terrific. I would love that.
I've got one of these. OK, here we go. This is for you, Jimmy. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. No, L, no.